Crossing Void's first set of limited units, or units that are a pair or multiple units of the same type, has finally come. Kimono Asuna and Kimono Shana are very interesting units, but are they up to the task? Are they worth pulling? Are they in waifu enough for you to want to pull? Well, I can only answer one of those questions, but first things first. If they are your waifu, pull for them, they won't be coming back for a while, and I'm not gonna lie, their art and effects seem pretty cool so far. Anyways, let's talk about Kimono Asuna's playstyle and abilities. Asuna's abilities altogether allow her to be a switch hitter, stance changer, or whatever you want to call it. Essentially, in order to min-max her, you have to use both her abilities and constantly switch between them. If you don't have Alice and want to try a unit that's pretty fun, I would recommend Asuna, as she plays as if she was an aggressive Alice. Well, the closest thing to that playstyle, but more offensive focused. Anyways, onto her abilities. Asuna's first ability is Flashing Penetrator, which is a hilarious name for an ability. But anyways, Flashing Penetrator is a 0 or 1 cost ability that deals AoE damage. After using the skill, she gains the Absolute Void status, which changes her climax skill into Flash Absolute Void and reduces the cost of her second skill, Phantom Moon. Just note, the skill is extremely strong at 0 and is still pretty okay at 1 cost. Asuna's second ability is Phantom Moon, a 3 or 4 cost AoE skill. After using this ability, she enters the Void Ripper status, which reduces the cost of her first skill, Flashing Penetration, by 1, and changes her climax skill to Flash Void Ripper. This skill has one of, if not the highest DPS per cost in the game when you use it at 3 skill points for a 3 skill point skill. Asuna's climax skill is a double skill, where to switch it you must either use your first or second ability. By default, since you start with the Void Ripper status, your climax is Flash Void Ripper, a 12 climax point skill that deals AoE damage and ignores damage taken reduction and shield. Holy shit, this is the first ability that does it and I'm scared. It does massive damage already, and the fact that even if an enemy uses damage reduction, like Akko or Tomoka S2, or has a shield on them, this skill completely bypasses it. This skill is insane. After using your first skill, it becomes Flash Absolute Void, an 8 climax costing skill that deals AoE damage and increases enemies' damage taken by 1 turn. Note, this is the highest damage taken we have in the game, and if you can pair it with a 12 point ultimate or more, this skill is insane because it'll add 1/3 of your damage as a base. If that was at all confusing to you, a short TLDR is that your skills make the other one cost one less, and your first skill makes your climax frail, while the second skill makes it deal damage and ignores damage reduction and shields. Playstyle-wise, since Asuna has extremely high damage per cost on all her abilities, especially when you reduce them, it seems best to keep switching between skills. While not maximizing your damage, you do end up maximizing efficiency, breaking the pattern when you feel you need a specific climax skill. Moving along to your crosses, when crossed with Alifa, their cross skill, In-Laws in Action, deals AoE physical damage and applies a wound effect on the enemy for 2 turns. While not super impressive, it also uses up a healer slot and allows you to use Olive Wood of Heracles, the impression weapon where if you attack a target with a wound, you have a chance to do bonus damage, and stacking this along with her exclusive talent is pretty fun. When crossed with Kuroyuki Hime, their cross skill, President and Vice President, a 4-cost single target skill that deals physical damage to the middle enemy. Just note, Kuroyuki Hime is one of the highest attack scalings in the game and is the second fastest unit with that trait. So if you're maximizing damage and want a single target ability to snipe out other units, Kuroyuki Hime is your best choice. Kimono Asuna's exclusive talent is Lightning Flash. If you deal damage with her and the enemy is above 70% HP, it'll apply a non-dispellable debuff that makes the enemy take more damage. Talent-wise, Kimono Asuna is an efficient DPS, so we're going to be running mainly damage. Percent attack is 100% needed as usual. We would also prefer to use Lightning Flash since it's pretty decent. Early on, you want to use percent HP and percent crit as you need to scale, and you can switch out percent HP for percent crit damage once you feel you have enough critical damage support. Set-wise, if you're playing for maximum efficiency, Poser set would be best to use, as with efficient usage of all your skills, they will cost 3 or less. However, if you want to play more of a nuking style, alternative fashion can work, especially when paired with Kuroyuki Hime, who can also use alternative fashion since her seal is 5 cost and their cross is 4. Kimono Asuna is definitely an interesting DPS character with numerous things going for her. Having high damage per cost once you lower the cost of your skills, having a 2-skill climax with 2 different effects, having the highest frail in the game, having the first damage reduction ignore and shield bypass, being able to cross with a great healer and great DPS. I would recommend you pull for her if you missed out on Alice to have a similar character and uniqueness, but also want a more DPS-y version of her. Not to say that she completely does more damage than a fully stacked Alice, but hey. So, let's move on to my favorite part of the video where I do a team building section for her. So, obviously, we're going to start out with Kimono Asuna, and for now, we want to play her as a full DPS, so we are going to run Kuroyuki Hime. So, a great teammate for someone who switches between a 0-cost skill and a 3-cost skill, or maybe even a 4-cost skill, would be someone who also switches between skills. So, I'm going to run Shauna. Shauna's best support, in my opinion, is Zero. Not because they cross or anything, but because I think Zero provides a perfect speed for Shauna, where Shauna will almost always be able to use her lead skill without being as slow as, say, Boogie Bob. So, just note, we don't really have that much healing, so what we could do, since we are using a lot of skill points anyway, we're going to be able to build up 5 skill points pretty fast in order to be able to use Akko's damage reduction buff, and being able to use her climax skill would be pretty neat and help us out in a lot of scenarios. However, we still do want an actual healer, so we're going to be running Leafa, as usual. You can also run Aerio, and that's perfectly fine. Those are 2 amazing healers that you can use for now. With this team, you're generally going to be consistently switching between 0 and 3 cost skill over here, and here you'll be switching between a 0 and 4 cost skill. And here, you can use Akko's S2 ability, which gives you a 50% damage reduction buff whenever you have free points or anything like that. Also, just remember, Akko's heal is pretty dang good, and Akko's a decently tanky unit, so having her in the front will be pretty good. Especially since Akko can heal herself using her S1. Also just note, you do have a double seal here, so maybe you do want to replace Zero with Boogie Bop. If only for the purpose of having a seal on 2 different units. Anyways, let's move on to a second team here. So, we're going to be building a team for Asuna and Leafa. Just note that your general turn rotation is going to be a little bit different when you want to climax. That's because you're going to want to use their cross skill if you have Olivewood Club of Heracles. You want to use that skill before you climax with a frail. So, because of that, well, you do want maximum damage involved. So, a really good candidate Well, some really good candidates would be Kirito with his Kuroyuki Hime cross, Alice, Shauna, Taiga, Miyuki would also be really good. However, for now, I think one of the best choices is going to be Mikoto. And the reason why we're going to run Mikoto is because when you cross her with Kuroko, you get a 6-cost skill that deals very high damage. Although Kuroko's scaling is very average, having a 6-cost skill that deals a lot of damage, since, note, we're going to be saving about 9 skill points every turn with Asuna right now, so using a 6-cost skill is fine to use for now in different places. With that, we have our DPS combination, and in the front, you can add whoever you want. But for now, a decent recommendation, since our team is pretty squishy right now, we can run Alice, since we're going to be able to use 3 skill points almost every single turn. We can use Kirino, would also be really good. We can use Akko. We can use Kirito. So, just because we want the lovers to be on the same team, we'll run Kirito. And with Kirito, we're going to put on him... Let's see, what would be a really good idea to add in with Kirito? We can add in 2 Asunas if we really wanted to. However, what this team is actually missing is another dispel, either a dispel or a removal of skills. So, you can have Kuroneko, Uehara, or Ryuji. I tend to like Ryuji because it adds a lot of shields to your team, and don't forget to equip the shield impression weapon on Ryuji as you see fit. Alrighty then, thank you guys for watching the Kimono Asuna character spotlight video. So next week we're going to be going over Kimono Shauna, who's going to be coming out on Tuesday, I believe. So stay tuned for that, guys. If you guys enjoyed, please leave a like, subscribe, and the notification bell, blah blah blah. I don't really care about that stuff, but it would really help me out if you guys did that. Also, I'm gonna be streaming on Twitch, so if you guys want to see me pull these kimono girls, use them, whatever, feel free to head on over there. Link will be down below. Also, I'm gonna be switching my upload days to Saturday just because it works out a little bit better. It also gives me a little bit more time to work on this specific guide series. Also, actually, that's pretty much it. So I'll see you guys next week. Come on to my stream because I'm going to be live when this video goes live. Thank you guys very much, and I hope to see you guys there.